Rugby Stadium here at Stanford University in beautiful Palo Alto, California. We have the D2 championship match between Mary Washington and Cal State Northridge. Both these sides looking to get started here quickly. What can we expect from this matchup?
Well, Mary Washington is actually probably going to be a little bit better today, as the number 10 flew in from graduation last night and is starting in her original 10 position tonight. California State Northridge has only been around for about 2 years, but they've developed into quite a powerhouse. They've got a really good fly half, fullback, and a speedy set of wings. So let's look for them to spread it wide, fast and often.
Absolutely. Stay tuned here for the action. We got some great rugby on offer here today. The D2 championship as the ladies take the field currently. Running onto the pitch. Great crowd here supporting the ladies. And on the left, the Cal State Northridge Matadors lining up.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the singing of our national anthem.
We'll have the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the singing of our national anthem.
This match underway. Both of these sides ready to compete in this D2 championship match. Mary Washington with great players such as Copper Carter is a force at tight head prop. We got Tina Rader as a former soccer player and impact player at fullback. Ashley Buxton scored 2 tries against Kent State in the round of 16. A lot of potent experience there for Mary Washington. Cal State Northridge Matadors. You got props, Ciara Waters Mullen and fly half Gillian Chance are the team's captains. Sarah McGee scored 3 tries at West Regionals. And there you have Captain Caragari on the wing. She scored 3 tries at West Regionals as well. All these ladies looking to put their mark in this game early on. We've got Alyssa McLean. She was a force to be reckoned with yesterday.
Had 2 tries in that first match.
Had 2 tries in her first match here at Stanford. Referee gets us underway. Great kickoff from the captain, Chance. Well taken by the number 7, Amy Everett. Taken past their 22. Ball out to the right. Well handled. Out to the 14. Catherine Hansen. The 10 takes it forward. Christina Rader. Oh, unlucky there. Playing advantage. The Matadors on the front foot here.
Unlucky. First knock here. Going down red.
Great stuff coming from. Great pressure from Cal State Northridge early on. Mary Washington, unlucky to have that unforced error right within their territory on the 22. Scrum down. Cal State ball to the side to go weak side. There's the captain. Out to her 12, Ashley Buxton. She muscles it up. Returning that ball, that's Sophia Thrall. Getting out to her four, it's right there. Number six, Sarah McGee taking it forward.
Cal State Northridge putting Mary Washington under a whole lot of pressure here right now. But Mary
quick tap. Yeah, Jade Law taking it forward.
Back up, Green! Back up, winger!
Clark comes
up
in to wrap it up. That's Camacho. To Murillo. To the one, Ciara Waters-Mullen. And she gets in for the try. The captain scores first. The Matadors are on the board early. Just 2 minutes gone in this D2 championship matchup.
Got to take a player that size low. Can't tire a tackle out there by the shoulders. Good try by her, though.
Oh, wonderful stuff there, Brandon. Absolutely over the line. Great try, great power. A lot of skill coming from the Matadors early on. Loving the pressure coming forward. Unforced error there from Mary Washington. They paid for it on that occasion.
Indeed they did. Nice to see Cal State come out here and start strong. They started a little slow yesterday and had to play from behind for a part of the game in their semifinal, but they're coming out all fires burning today.
Absolutely. Here to take the point after, 2 points after. Looks like the captain, Gillian Chance, doesn't get this one on this occasion, but what a start for Cal State. It's exactly how they wanted to begin this match, getting on the board early.
Yeah, first year coach Christina Alatorre got to be happy with how their team started.
Absolutely. Alatorre, first time coach for this Northridge team. Little cheeky chip forward. Well taken to the number two, Jessica Murillo. Great fend off by the eight, Gabrielle Schmeling.
Coming back to the short side. Right.
That's McGee. Back to the up inside. Murillo tries for the pass to Chance. Looks like Mary Washington ball here. Turnover. Then Matador territory. We got Law digging it out of the back. Finding her 12. That's Camacho. She had a great day yesterday as well. A lot of pace. There's the 15. Coda. Out to the wing.
Jillian Chance. Scooting up there, but unfortunately it's pushed out of bounds.
Red ball.
Definitely
red
dangerous
ball.
Here. Both teams getting blows early. 5-0 in favor of Cal State. Mary Washington threatening. Now it's the Cal State Northridge throw-in. Murillo, see if she can find her jumper. Turn over to Mary Washington. Then Matador territory. Law digs it out. Great loop there, looking out for the danger woman. And McLean.
Referee
says play on.
Jillian Chance slicing and dicing, scooting through. They're finding the gap.
Oh, the captain with the offload to the number eight. Brianna Bowling. Ball squirting loose there in the corner. Could have been a knock on there, but referee says play on. Great run by the captain.
Knock on. 5 yards front.
Run, ladies. Keep it up.
Down the left touchline. Brilliant stuff. Exciting play to start this match.
back and forth action. It's nice to see. Nice to see in a national championship game.
Absolutely. Matadors have an opportunity to relieve the pressure. Put in from Thrall. Great push by Mary Washington. The egg picks up and dives over. Brianna Burling.
That's quite the statement right there by Mary Washington for the pushover try.
That's got to be a point where they're going to come back to the front row of Alicia Almberg, Brianna Barr, and Copper Carter. Absolutely decimated the front. Here's the replay. Great push in, turnover ball. Brianna just having to pick it up and dive over the line. Great forwards try there with a kick to come from the corner. Number 9, Jade Law. Brandon, we just had two early tries come in within the first 6 minutes of this match. Both teams ready to fire here. Unlucky kick there. Not what you wanted there, but tied at 5 apiece.
5 apiece, about 6.5 minutes gone. Still a lot of time, still a lot of time.
Absolutely. Here we go. Cal State with a kickoff. Co-captain Gillian Chance with the kick. Sends it deep. Oh, well taken. And she crashes forward. That looked like Carter Moore. Out wide, great set of feet here. Little Simi shaking a fed from the 13. Maddie Ernesto, well done Maddie. Try scorer, gets it out to the wing. Gabby a chance. Or Christina Rader, excuse me.
Release Brent, back, back.
Loop play again, 14 reads it, know what the, gotta use two hands in that situation. Alyssa McClain.
That's play on. The danger woman, no, not held. Oh, maybe she was.
That's a rough call.
Penalty. Matadors. And Mary Washington's half.
Alyssa McClain back to cover the kick. Just about 20 meters outside of their try zone.
It's a great attacking platform for the Matadors. Looking to come away with more points here. Number 2, Brianna Barr. Oh, excuse me, Jessica Murillo, the throw on the ball. Jade Law with the service.
Oh,
nearly picked off.
Close to the interception.
Well done
there
by Kofas to get that ball.
14 with it behind the tackle. Good job.
Avella getting dragged down by the scruff of her neck.
Do the knockback.
There was a previous knock on. The play was allowed to continue. See if advantage could be gained.
Let's see if George Washington or Mary Washington can put the same amount of pressure underneath on Cal State Northridge as they did down there, right outside their try zone.
And that was an impressive scrum that led to the try earlier on from Brianna Burling. Scrum down. We have Sophia Thrault putting in the ball. Nope, Northridge ball, excuse me. Jade Law.
Better scrum by Cal State.
Back out to Chance. She fends. She wants to go herself. Camacho in support, but stolen
by Samantha Hogue.
Space out to the left. They get into the danger woman. McClain. She gets wrestled up in the tackle. Unruly ball there from the ruck. Play on, says the referee.
That ball is out, that's fine. Nice steal,
home. Giving it a big old number 3.
Red
Carter.
Back, back.
Just outside the 22.
Good counter.
Matador counter ruck.
Working the ball out wide, getting it to the speed.
Over the top, intercept. Referees playing advantage. No advantage gained.
Not rolling away is the call. It's unfortunate to see.
Mary Washington did roll away from the previous rock. Advantage was not gained. Now the penalty.
Jade looking to take a tap here, finding a forward runner. Looks like she's going to the eight. Schmeling.
Great
taking a few
move.
With her.
That's fine. Thank you.
Law at the back. Pick and go from the seven. Aaliyah Woods.
Seven drag down behind by their Carter again.
Turnover ball. Uh-oh, could be something here.
Hands in.
A referee calling in Mary Washington.
Just having a little chit chat. Tell him, hey, please clean this up a little bit. Come on, it's a national championship game. We need more. We need better effort from you guys.
Well, just too many infractions within the 22. Desperation tactics, maybe. Lucky not to get a yellow card here. You don't want to do that. A 5-5 match. Don't want to be down a man, especially with this potent Matador attack.
Especially this early in the game. You don't want to set the tone with a yellow card. Cal State Northridge setting up in the column.
And again, Law goes with the tap, goes to the six. McGee. Oh, nice inside ball. Schmeling. Powering her way forward. Law trying to dig it out the back. Looking for chance. Camacho.
There's a gap.
Kofis. He gets to her 15 and Coda. Not making much real estate by Law. Trying to get around the corner. Turnover.
Number 15, Ho comes up with it again.
Thrown forward by Mary Washington.
She gets scrubbed down to the Matadors, and they are just knocking on the door. You got to think that Mary Washington needs to get this ball out of their zone. Well, the Matadors are going to come away with points. It's a territory game. The longer you spend in your opposition's end, the more likely you are to get points on the board. Matadors just keep on maintaining possession and keeping the pressure on.
Mary Washington's running a really effective blitz defense right now, and it's working well against Cal State Northridge just because their attack is so shallow and open play.
Schmeling takes that ball off the back, decides to go weak side. Popped in the tackle, knock on. Mary Washington gets out of trouble here. Looks like we got the 10, Christina Rader. Hopefully looking for some service from Thrault. There he is at the back.
Good pass under pressure, good clearance kick.
Kick does not find touch. Goes to the 15. Out to the wing. Danger woman, Kathleen Kagari. Defending 1-2. Great matchup there with the wingers. And again, a little knock on there. Not being able to handle it in the tackle. That's Catherine Kagari. She's been dangerous. Scored 3 tries at West Regionals. She knows how to score. Mary Washington ball outside their 22. Kicking a touch, probably not an option here. Stolen ball, Schmeling off the back, going strong side. Finding chance.
Got numbers out wide. Use the one more. Number 11 turns on the Jets. Fighting for the try line.
Down Villa. Back to Camacho.
Get out.
With the forwards now. Oh, sneaky little pickup right. And Jade Law gets hammered.
Ooh,
oh, what a hit from the 8, Brianna Burling. The try scorer.
Referee says play on, went back.
Sierra Waters Mullen, the try scorer, gets hauled down. Still going up inside. Murillo to Kagari. Camacho. Inside back to Murillo, and she loses it. There's McLean picking up the ball for Mary Washington.
Mary Washington playing the advantage from the referee. Would appear, Colin, would appear that they're Cal State Northridge just getting playing into that frenetic pace that they got in trouble with in the first game yesterday. They need to calm down, settle down, do what they were doing at the very start when they let into that try and just play their system and not be frantic with these, what did you say, 50-50 offloads?
Yeah, we've seen the frantic pass out of contact, the 50-50. I hope somebody's behind me. Please pick this up. You know, the team that actually finds their structure and runs through the phases sooner is the team that usually comes out on top. And Mary Washington with a half arm, happy to kick it through. Well fielded, Kagari steps back inside. Looking for McGee, back to the 12, Camacho.
Oh, and the advantage being played, Mary Washington yet again.
Another turnover. Mary Washington relieves the pressure, forces the turnover. Scrum down, Mary Washington.
Mary Washington's kicks need to find those touch lines or get it out of bounds, because those Cal State Northridge kids are too fast.
You see the fans in the stands go, Mary Wash. Great support out here for both teams as we get Jade Lott of service. Sophia Thorault, service out to the right. Great kick through from Ashley Buxton, and a great tackle from her. Turnover to Mary Washington. To McLean. She gets tackled by the captain and chance. Ball gets back. Thorault.
Looking for the same loop play. They've got numbers out wide if they can use it.
Ernesto. Pressure coming up from the Matadors. Could have caused a turnover here, and they do. Wow, chance. Can she get it out again? Begari unable to handle it. Coming down under her. McLean and bottles her into touch.
Good hit by McLean to force the Cal Northridge Matador into touch. McLean's down.
Mary Washington going quickly.
McLean is down. Looked like she might have knocked the wind out of herself. Taking a second.
Here's a replay coming in. We got chance coming across. That's McGee getting the ball to Kagari. And then here's McLean barreling down at her, getting in her touch. Looks like she got the wind knocked out of her on that play. Still recovering, and now she's up. Now she's up on the sideline.
She's good to go.
Getting some attention going. She's a competitor. She's ready to run.
Talented trainers.
Just looks like she took her shot to the middle of the diaphragm. And here we go. Mary Washington put in.
Good ball movement by Mary Washington.
Ernesto. Oh. Raider unable to hold on to that pill. Ball goes into touch. Here we go now, Matador throw-in near the halfway. Both teams locked at five apiece with 20 minutes gone in this D2 championship match. Great looking throw, Matadors have it off the back, off to the captain chance. Great pill there. Passing out to Kagari, she can't handle it. Referee says knock on.
I just heard somebody yell from the sidelines, pick that ball up. Nobody really seems to want possession of that ball. Everybody's kind of fly hacking at it. We just need to fall down on that, settle it down. You want that ball, you need that ball. That's how you're gonna win this game.
Yeah, absolutely, I concur. The team that's gonna maintain possession, play through the phases, is gonna get on the board again here. As we got a steep back line set up. The 15, Samantha Hoag, slotting in at 10.
Buxton scooting over to the weak side. Looks like something's up.
Hoag to Ernesto. Great looking switch there with Hansen.
Red move! That's fine. Next one,
Red! Turn over to the Matadors.
Hands in the rock, referee giving the penalty to Mary Washington. Kyle Northridge quick to retreat their 10 meters.
And there you have it, Brandon. Absolutely holding on possession here in the half. They keep on getting the plays, getting the penalties, and moving forward as number three, Copper Carter, takes it crashing up through the middle.
Cal State Northridge, though, looking like they're going to try to counter-ruck this. The number nine digging and scrounging for it.
Oh, it's a turnover.
Looking for the clearance kick, but it... Oh.
Trance over the top of McLean.
That was a good kick, and the mandatory water break at the 20-minute mark because of the heat. As you've heard us probably mentioned in the first half. It's hot weather out.
Okay,
they need it.
Yeah, nice little break for the ladies here. And now. Ladies get together, have a little cool down. Not bad having a nice little break after 20.
No, not in temperatures like this and after 80 minutes of rugby yesterday.
And now, a word from our sponsors, AIG. AIG is a proud sponsor of USA Rugby. AIG is a leading international insurance and financial services organization serving commercial, institutional, individual customers in more than 130 countries. Absolutely wonderful to have AIG's support here in this championship weekend. And we'll be back with more action as soon as the water break is over. Thanks for staying tuned here, USA Rugby TV.
Welcome back to Stuber Rugby Stadium. Sitting here with Colin Holly, Cal Rugby Star, USA Rugby Star, star of a lot of things. Calling the game of Mary Washington in the white and gray against Cal State Northridge in the red, black,
oh,
and white.
Oh, what a run!
She's going
what a
somewhere.
Line.
She's out of here.
Straight through the middle. That's Christina Rayner.
She was running like she had somewhere to go, Colin. Running like she had somewhere to go.
She went through that defensive line like a hot knife through butter.
That's a good out.
Wow, what pace. Let's check out the replay. Well-orchestrated move here. Nice little loop. Look at this hot line straight through the middle. That is pace and power and precision. Wonderful stuff from Christina Rader, their fullback coming in, injecting just a massive amount of pace into that attacking platform. Wow.
They're going to have to figure out how to stop that, because otherwise they're going to need to call Kenny Loggins, because they're going to be in the danger zone.
What a wonderful set piece move from Primary Thays. The Matadors have been in Mary Washington's end most of this half.
Mary Washington up 12 to Cal State Northridge's 5. With about 20 minutes gone in the first half.
Absolutely, converted try there. And Gillian Chance for the kickoff here, the co-captain. Nice long kick.
Into the empty space, bouncing around.
Right behind Carter Moore. But here we go again, the try scorer getting some moves in. Play on. Out to the back. Nice little switch move with Buxton. Hogue trying to ship it out to Ernesto, and that's a turnover. There could be something here. She ships it out to the wing. Evelyn Avila has got to score down in the corner. And the Matadors answer back.
Exactly what they needed to do.
Just a little bit of sloppy play, a turnover right when you don't need it. Here's the replay. Ernesto couldn't handle a pass. There's the 13, Kofis. Nice set of hands out to number 11, Evelyn Avila. And she scores down in the corner. She's got to be happy with that. 10-12 brings her team closer with a kick to come to even the score line.
The Matadors have made a sub. Number 19, Ashley Gomez, has come on for Stephanie Alonzo in the front row.
Big kick here for the captain, Chance. Well struck, really well struck.
Just not good. Outside.
Not good. All right. More action comes. 16 minutes to play in this first half. The D2 championship for the women's. We're getting underway with Thorault's kick. Not handled well there by the Matadors. A chance for Mary Washington to put on the pressure here.
Looking to move it out wide now, trying to get it through the fast kid's hands.
There you go. Camacho.
Good defensive play there by McLean, sitting in that channel, cutting off the offload.
Going to the back. Coda finding her forwards outside her. One-handed offload pass from Murillo.
Referee playing the advantage from the knock-on. Ball goes back to Mary Washington.
And again, you see the Matadors giving up a silly penalty there. Just another one of those 50-50s, one-handed offload, flinging it behind it. I hope you get it.
Yep. I hope somebody's there. I hear you, but I don't see you.
We need to just get a little structure to their attack, play the phases. Steep wide set, a lot of real estate to the open side here.
There they go, there they go. 15-12, moving over, looking for that space. Cal State Northridge looking to spin that scrum.
Well, going right. The Buxton. Buxton, little cheeky chip through. Hope gives chase. Chance is going to make it there. And she made it there first. 22 meter dropout. Awesome job by the captain, Chance, to make it back there and touch that ball.
Yeah, that's a good play when you're up. I mean, they're winning the game. There's little damage that could be done.
You know, two-point game, you're in their end. You haven't been there very often if you're Mary Washington to kick that ball away. It's a risky play. Definitely wanted that to come away with points, but get the ball back and a chance to counter on this 22-meter.
It's an investment, too, because now they're going to think, oh, she might kick on us. It might slow down that blitz defense, open up a gap somewhere else for somebody.
Captain with the ball, looking to hoof this thing downfield. Great take by the 10, the try scorer, Raider. She's going to have a go. There's McLean. Oh.
Just the heels. Just her heels touch that line.
Hard done there to trying to tiptoe down the touchline. Watch the replay here. She scored two yesterday, but there's the try scorer. Great counterattack. Nearly stripped, though. And here's McLean, nice little fan, but see there, just barely touches the line.
Couple blades of grass out.
Here's the throw-in from Marilla.
Oh, that's behind him, back here.
Obstruction's a call. And again, Mary Washington staying in the Matador territory.
Camping out down here.
Thorault digging it out. Fighting Alicia Allenberg. She's well met. Out to the right, Hogue. Finding Ernesto. Oh, stolen.
Oh. Here we go with Cal State Northridge.
Wild pass there. Law to Murillo.
Again with the obstruction call. This is the problem with Cal State Northridge. They try to get that ball out so fast, but they're so flat that they're running behind each other. The referee yesterday let it get away a little bit, but this referee has no business with it.
A little bit of frantic play. You got to see them there running around, trying to find somebody. Sometimes you put your head down, you drive forward, and you set the ball down, you set the ruck. And you play a phase of rugby.
Yep, start your attack all over again.
Going to quick tap here. Thorault.
Red, one,
finding roll. Carter. McForm. Finding Hogue. She wants to go wide.
Looking for the number.
Switch with the try score. Ball squirts out the back. There's Buxton.
It's fine.
Buxton busts us up.
Ball
squirts out again. Amy Everett takes it up. Matadors. Great line coming up. Defense just knocking Mary Washington back right now.
Mary Washington is playing good phase ball and retaining possession, which is a good start to set something up.
It's a good run by Moore. Just seems like the breakdowns are just hectic right now. Mm-hmm. The ball's going a bit everywhere. It's got to be tough for those nines to resource that pill.
Yeah. Happy I'm not a scrum half today.
We got a lady down. That looks like the lock, number five, Carter Moore, receiving some attention there from the training staff.
She's up. She's going to soldier on. That's a championship.
She subs off the help. Yeah. I'm good. I'm playing on. Don't worry about me. Soldiering on. Scrum down.
Come on. Come on. Let's go, Gray. I'm waiting for you. Down. Crouch. Fine.
Sophia with the put-in. There you go, the try score, number eight, Brianna Burling. Picking weak to Hogue. Dummy switch out to Ernesto. Unable to handle that pill, but she does well to resource it. Another good counterattack coming in from the Matadors. Yes, they probably turn this one over.
I think the Matadors have turned it over. Not rolling away is a call by the referee.
And great defensive presence right there from Cal State, just to keep Mary Washington out and keep their defensive structure long enough to get this penalty. Pretty long way to the touchline here for the captain Chance. Probably need a good chase on the outside.
She keeps it in and she's kicking it to one of the players you probably
Danger
don't
woman.
Want to do.
Raider. Password backsword. Buxton, looking for the counter.
Looking for the
she
kick.
She finds a little space in behind.
She's got her own good chase ball.
Coda, that's a wise play by 15.
Smart play by Cal State, Northridge's
looking
15,
to go quick.
Mandy Cotts.
And they do. Mary Washington playing the quick lineup.
Mary Washington is here to play today.
Absolutely pushing the tempo.
You're wrong. Nope.
And again, oh, quick tap. Great job there.
Oh, the offload to the referee.
That's unfortunate. It's a great heads-up play by Thorault, getting that quick tap in and pushing the tempo of this game. We had the quick line out to the quick tap. I mean, you got the sense that's their tactic. They want to go quick and catch this Matador team off guard.
See if they're sleeping today.
Steep line set. From Mary Washington, Hoggett.
McLean's been quiet for too long in this game. Let's see what she can do here. She's sitting out there in the 11 shirt.
There's the ball.
Gonna play
it backwards.
They're looking
Dummy.
For her. They're looking
There's
for
There's a gap. There's
there
McLean.
She that's what she needed.
She's got the pace to get this over the line. And that's the danger woman. She had two yesterday.
Ooh.
Little how you doing after the play, but yeah. She's all right.
Alyssa McLean was just like, it's okay.
Check out the replay here. We knew this ball was gonna go wide. Buxton, little show and go, gets the gap. And then the pure pace on the outside for McLean to get around her opposite number there. Gargaria and dot it down. Little bit of an extra little something after the play, but I'm sure it wasn't malicious. McLean getting her third for the weekend. Absolutely needed here for Mary Washington to extend their lead. 7 points up with a kick to come to make it a two possession game for the Matadors to come back here. And the approach.
Pushes it a little outside wide to the left.
Unlucky, one score game here for the Matadors. With 7 minutes to play in this half, you'd think that they want to get on the front foot and answer back here if you're Cal State Northridge. Chance again to get us started here. Not as well struck, goes to the two. Brianna Barr, she does well to get that back to her team.
CSU's committing a lot of players.
Matadors, too much to handle on the counter rock, and it goes to McGee. Chance, spinning out, gets her hands free, gets it to Camacho. And here's Law, looking to the right.
A lot of numbers out here to the right, Colin.
Ooh, finding Ashley Gomez.
Good
and
switch by the two and the one.
Great switch coming from the forwards there.
From the side. Love to see a team with switching forwards.
Three great from the side.
And then again, Mary Washington giving up to the penalty. Chance with a touch finder. Uh-oh, did she touch it?
Looked like the touch judge signal that she did not touch it. Talking it out with the captain, what do you want to do? She says I'll be happy to take that ball all the way back up there.
Yeah, lucky for the captain there. She's been so good on the foot so far this half in this game.
There's a gust that's kind of coming across the field every now and again. That's probably going to affect the kicking a little bit today.
Yeah, a little inaccuracy there for the kick. You want to make sure you get that thing into touch. Now Mary Washington with the kill. Just outside there, 22. Samantha Hoke slotting in at 15. She's in the 10 spot. Well, the Hoke. She wants Ernesto, she finds her.
Good take by Ernesto coming up in there using the fend, creating a little bit of space in the contact situation.
Oh, Hogue, finding a little room to run there. Oh, the tri-scorer gets hit by Lilla. Matador ball.
Ooh,
yikes.
Good counter rock by the number one there.
Oh, and they push back. Play on. Number 19, Ashley Gomez takes it up. Great stuff from her. Space out to the left and they get it back out there. Camacho, one-handed offload. Can Avila go for two?
Pushed out.
Some more back and forth. Here's the replay coming in here. Absolutely great hands coming out to the side. Camacho, look at that one-handed offload, getting her hands free. That's Evelyn Avila. She's already got one today, forced into touch there, but backing herself to make it to the corner, putting the pressure on Mary Washington, deep in their own end.
Overthrowing. Going back.
Oh, no.
Radar.
Bobbled pass.
Knock on by Christina Radar right there. Let's see if Cal State Northridge can do anything with this opportunity.
And here we go, scrum down to the Matadors. We've got Jade Law to put it in. There's the service. Great push on. She goes strong side, finds Chance, out to Camacho.
Good pressure there by Radar.
Kofis gets tackled.
Good attempt at counter ruck, and a successful counter ruck by Mary Washington. Good kick out of there by Thrall.
Oh, not handled by the winger.
Unlucky for the winger there.
God, you just notice the intensity at the breakdown. Both of these ladies, teams just pushing each other over the ball. You gotta think
here,
that the team that commits to the breakdown. I think that's got to be something. Each team goes in the halftime. Mm-hmm. We're too many turnovers at the breakdown. You have your own ball. You got to get there and support.
Yep. Commit to doing the breakdown right. Low body position, good leg drive. Get a fast ball for your nine.
There you go. Brianna pumping up her team for the scrum.
Watch your guys' heads when you line up.
Another word from the referee here.
Crouch! Line! Set!
We're out to put in. And there's the service. Good platform. Out the hook. Nice little loop. Fake switch by Anissa. McLean can't handle this one. Hogue recovers. McLean picks up, cleans up the dirty ball.
Thank you.
More contention at the ruck here. They go wide.
Radar again looking to do some work. Good fend off, but not enough.
What a great job by the captain. They get Buxton bundled into touch. Here's the replay here. Coming outside. Here's Raider. Great offload, and Buxton not able to fend off the captain's chance. Getting her in a touch. Now Matador ball at Mary Washington's 22.
Good take by
Murillo,
the jumper.
Murillo finds her mark. The chance. Steps inside the tackler.
The advantage is being played would appear to be a high tackle by the referee.
Kalfas, Avala, can't she get the fend again? She goes back to Law. Law looped around. Great ball back inside. Camacho's got it.
Still playing advantage.
Still playing the advantage. He would go back to the original penalty spot, which for what I believe was a high tackle. Yep. Putting them right in the middle of the field.
Your tackle's lower.
Time winding down here. This has got to be the last play for the Matadors to get in. Uneven the scoreline. They find the co-captain in Ciara Waters-Mullen. She busts through.
Last one, try and move.
Nice inside ball.
Great inside ball.
To McGee.
Unfortunate forward pass there. That is half.
Great job by both sides here today. Wonderful matchup, 10-17. Mary Washington holding on to a 7-point lead. Cal State unlucky to get in there, but both teams threatening the line. It seems like Cal State has had most of the territory being in Mary Washington's end, but Mary Washington converting on some of these breakout plays with McLean coming out and Radar with that wonderful primary phase strike move through the middle that scored the try earlier. What do the teams want to talk about here at halftime? Kind of get some more structure on the play.
I would first focus on the breakdown situation. They've really, really got to settle those rucks down. Somebody's got to win it either way. You know, if they can fix that, I think both teams should open up the attack.
Absolutely. I think the breakdown's a big point of contention here. Both teams getting pushed off the ball.
Here we see the drive over scrum by Mary Washington. First drive, Brianna Burling. Thoughts over, fall over try there. Here we go with Radar, making the break, going somewhere, going hard, going fast, dotting down right underneath the uprights.
What a knife right through the Matador defense. And here we go, little mishap play from Ernesto. Kofis finding Avila on the wing. Great pin and pass there. Great show of skills from the turnover and take advantage of an opportunity there. Now here we go. Here's the last clip coming in. Nice little show and go.
The old danger
out
woman. Alyssa McLean.
To McLean. She had two earlier. Gets her third today. Dots down and gives her team the lead. A little bit of extra bump there. Not malicious, but we're here. Halftime in this D2 championship match. More to come after the break. Stay with us.
No, I'm good.
Okay, so it's your penalty. Okay. As long as you're not in front of her. Okay, so
And welcome back to Steuben Rugby Stadium here at Stanford University. We have the second half action of the Women's D2 Championship Final between Mary Washington and Cal State Northridge Matadors. Mary Washington right now with a 7-point lead ahead. They're gonna be kicking off the ball here. What do we have to do here in the second half from both sides to keep this match competitive?
Mary Washington needs to keep that tempo up. Cal State Northridge just needs to settle down. It's almost a contrast of the two styles. That's what they need to do to get in this game and win this thing.
A little bit of accuracy, a little bit of calming down, a little bit of pumping up. Championship rugby here. Cheeky kickoff to begin the match.
Oh.
Not going 10. Mary Washington trying to get a little cute with that cheeky kick, cheeky kickoff. Trying to catch the Matador sleeping. Didn't work out too well. Scrum down the middle of the field.
It would appear from first glance at the field that there's been no subs made at half by either team.
And here we go. Scrum down in the middle of the field. We got Jade Law servicing the scrum. Good platform at the back. Bottled up.
Good pressure by Thralton and a turnover as well.
Well done. Mary Washington with the pill. Happy to keep it tight with the forwards right now. Thoreau gets up. And there's a penalty. Matadors, little old discipline. Thoreau hoofs it to the left.
Oh.
Over the head.
Good bounce, finds touch.
Of Catherine Kergari. Great heads up play, going quick.
Not messing around, looking to win the.
That's McLean wanting to push the tempo here.
Push out of bounds, though.
Scrum down to the Matadors. Cheeky little kick there from Thorault, right behind Cargia's head, finding touch.
And a good follow up with the quick lineup of McLean and finding, I think it was Thorault again. Thorault's all over the place.
Right, we saw Mary Washington in the first half going quick taps, quick lineouts, cheeky kicks. Off the kickoff, they're really trying to push the tempo of this match. Chance with the clearance. She does well there, right out to the 22. A lot of pressure coming from her at the 10 spot.
Right now, the 10 for Cal State Northridge is keeping them in the game with their strategic kicking.
Yeah, she's been doing a phenomenal job so far. I think only on one occasion she didn't find touch, yep. But could have been due to the wind. Matador ball here. Chance, again, goes to the boot. High up and under.
Oh.
Unable to grab it, Christina Rador. Oh, Camacho.
Play to the whistle.
No, playing now without the ball, back.
Oh, Mary Washington penalized, and they go quick.
Referee Lee Bryant.
It's Avila, Camacho with the ball again. taking it up the guts. J-Lock digging it out, looking to the right, finding the two Marilla. She goes out to share one of them, but she stripped.
The ball.
Contact skills so important here in ball security. There's Hogue finding the inside runner.
No, 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 don't touch it.
Felicia Omberg. Hogue coming out to the right. Great option to put the kick in.
Ball's got a roll on it.
Coda looking for the counterattack possibility. She goes to the foot. Right over McLean's head. Will she go quickly here?
Finds touch. Good little kick by the 15 there.
Coda's been doing well in the deep three, managing the other wings and covering those kicks. Great option there for the fullback to relieve the pressure. She knew support wasn't behind her. Finding space over the head of McLean. Line out to Mary Washington.
Not straight as the call. They'll bring it back here. Give Northridge the option. Do you want a line out or a scrum? They choose line out.
Matadors with a line out within Mary Washington territory. Morella's been pretty spot on with her throws so far.
Scrum down, Greg.
Not straight again. Referee will make the decision for him. We're going to a scrum, folks.
Okay. Yeah, it's been tough here. We've got a little bit of a breeze. Could be a factor coming in for those line-out throwers. Don't have to worry about the breeze on the ground. Absolutely not.
No, sir.
Scrum down. Mary Washington ball. Right impact. All looks to be stolen here by the Matadors, and it is. Law to Chance. Through the legs of Camacho. Kofas has to go back to clean it up. Coda Avila can't pick it up.
Doing the soccer skills. Oh.
Tipped through by Hansen.
Referee Lee Bryant will play the knock, give the ball back to Mary Washington just on their side of the field there.
You can hear the fans on the sideline cheering on our ladies in this championship match. Championship rugby at its finest here for the D2 championship. We've got Sophia Thorold to put the ball in here. And stolen again
against
by the Matadors.
Good little poke right there.
Picks up, passes inside to Chance. Chance looks for the foot.
He's running.
Oh, danger woman in the back, Christina Rader. Looking to counterattack on the outside.
Oh, she's
rounding
going somewhere.
The winger. She's got the pace.
Wow, what
steps
a step.
Steps inside. They're not going to catch her. She's going to go in for her second of the match. What a counterattack.
I would tell you what I wouldn't do next time is kick to her.
Wow, is she dangerous or is she dangerous? Absolutely great show of speed and vision from Christina Rea. Look at the replay here. She gets the ball, rounds 14, and Catherine Kagari, who's absolutely got a huge injection of pace, great cutback inside. Jade Law can't grab her, and she just coasts in for the try. Nice little slide. Brilliant stuff from her. She goes in for her second, looking to give Mary Washington a two-try lead.
Conversion is missed by Thrall.
12 points the difference here between this matchup. The Matadors need to find something here to fight back. 8 minutes gone in this second half. Here's some Northridge fans cheering on their women. Chance, the captain, needs to find some inspiration here. And again, another beauty of a restart.
Going to the empty space in the field on that side.
Hansen against Avila. Nice offload inside. Look at the fend from Buxton. Still scrappy at the break, and it's a turnover.
She again kicks it back into
the kick. Not
but you don't
want to
kick that
to. McLean fending her way. Oh,
whoa,
what a fend.
Whoa.
She just fended off four defenders on the outside. Finally gets bottled into a touch. And slams the ball down with authority. She's ready. Check out this replay here. She catches the kick. One, two, three, four. And there's the fifth. Right to the face. Making her presence felt here. Not only fast, but power as well. There's McLean. Matador ball. Law. Camacho. Out to Kofis. She's looking for Gergia. Looking around the outside, can't get around Buxton.
Release!
Nice pickup there.
CSU suddenly has some structure. They're doing something with it.
Fend.
And they have numbers outside.
High tackle there.
Referee says no, play
on. Woods doing a great job to keep her feet. And again, ball's in play. Marissa Navarro.
Unlucky.
Sarah McGee wanted that ball.
Again, referee Lee Bryan giving a little talk about you gotta get your tackles lowered, ladies, Mary Washington team.
Bryan certainly had her hands full here, just been scrappy at the breakdown all day. Put into Mary Washington. Thorault to put in. Hogue at 10, waiting for the service. They love that loop.
Yeah, they have
Ernesto,
back
to McLean.
Oh,
she shakes the tackler, tries to fend off Kofis.
Good counter ruck by the wing there.
Wow. The Matadors busting through and getting the turnover. Nice pop-up pass. Law doing everything she can to get the ball alive. There's number 19, Ashley Gomez, getting right in the mix. Oh, what an offload.
To have hands on the outside, that little number 11 who's been the try scorer for CSU sitting there waiting. Give me the ball. Evelyn Avila. Unlucky.
Unlucky there. Advantage, Mary Washington.
Mary Washington has no fear running it out of the 22 like this.
They're backing themselves. I like this play. You don't want to get willy-nilly with the ball and start throwing around a little bit.
You are correct, sir.
Busting up the middle.
There's
a counter.
Knock on by CSU.
Check out the replay here. We've got Locke keeping it alive. And here comes the tackle. Boom. There's the physicality of this match. Absolutely. Claire Bauer getting her bell rung there.
Free kick to Mary Washington.
Oh, they decided to go quick. She's not 10.
Referee Lee Bryan recognizes that, telling him you need to get back 10 and hurry. Hogue with a good kick down. Can't you keep it?
Oh, beauty.
That was a good play. That was a good attempt by Evelyn Avila, though, right there to keep that alive.
That was a great kick for a right-footed kicker on the right side of the touchline. Wonderful stuff. We got the 7 from Mary Washington. Amy Everett to throw the ball in here. You'd think they'd hit Brianna Burling up front, and they go to her.
Try to.
It's stolen. Murillo back, chasing it back. Law.
Avila attempted the kick, but was brought down in the air halfway through it. 13 scoots through, though. She's free. She's going for the run. That's the problem with that offloading style. Sometimes when you're like that, when you're deep in your zone like that, you just need to go forward and set that ruck. Otherwise, a player like Ernesto will wait for the opportunity to pick it and go.
Maddie Ernesto, here's the replay. Little bit of adventurous play here for the Matadors. Trying to kick it, bouncing around the ball. She doesn't get a hand on it. And look at Ernesto, just picking it up, snatching. Nobody between her and the try zone. Easy to dot down into the sticks. That's what we were talking about before.
Well,
sometimes works out for you to
Colin,
play.
We've got some drama unfolding right now as the touch judge has come onto the field to discuss something with referee
Lee Ryan.
We have possibly the knock after the kick.
Okay. I have a late tackle.
There's a late tackle.
Late. Okay. This is going to be a penalty. That's we've talked to your team about this.
Uh-oh.
Next one, no mas.
Okay. Using the no mas.
No mas.
Time's on.
Referee says that the high it was a late tackle. The penalty is going to Cal Northridge. That is a costly mistake.
Free card. Yep. Wow. That's a silly tackle after the play. Mm-hmm. And he missed out on a try from Ernesto.
Lee Bryant.
Shame for her not to get the credit for that. She did well there, but now the quick tap. Seeing some space. Chance wants to run. McGee not able to handle it. Huge pop. From Copper Carter.
Kenneth White.
CSU working hard to counter those rocks.
Advantage not gained. Knock on by red. Storm down gray. Or white, whatever which one comes out first.
And here we go for the replay here. Nice offload. McGee just can't handle it. Look at that tackle coming across.
Crouch!
Copper Carter. She's been laying hot all afternoon. Scrum down to Mary Washington.
Ball scoots out.
McGee wraps
red
up
for off. Release. Thank you.
Service out the back. Fake switch. Buxton. She's been dangerous. Finds some space inside. Still going. Well tackled by the captain.
George, Mary Washington needs to be a little lower in that contact to win those rucks.
Outside.
And here she goes again. Raider. Oh,
what
beautiful
offload. Can't she get over? Stop short of the line. Great
that
cover tackle.
Play on.
From Mandy Cota.
CSU's turned the ball over. Captain kicks it out again.
Sends the touch.
Man, that was a.
Here's the replay coming in here. Look at this play. Raider been so dangerous all afternoon. Look at that pass. Getting tackled, the presence of mind to know where her winger is. And McLean coming at pace. Matador is doing a great job to keep him out of the try zone. Cove is getting the kick to touch there, relieving a bit of pressure, but still being pinned down within their 22. They got to get out of there or something's going to break.
Yeah, you can't play defense for 40 minutes, Colin.
Uh-oh. Not straight. What would you like, Red? Scrum. Not straight. Scrum here.
Right, coming down for the
scrum.
Some
an advantage, but it didn't happen.
So, Colin, this far into the game, who do you think is a standout player for Mary Washington?
Oh, I think that's easy right now. That's Christina Rader. The injection of pace and power that she's put on this match has definitely put Mary Washington on the front foot. Unbelievable counterattack try. First half, she had the set piece slice right through the middle. But here we go. Wow, putting in the ball. And she goes to the foot. Dangerous play. Giving it back to the danger woman.
Good offload, but
nice loop to Ernesto. She one-handed offloads to Hanson. Hanson bottled up. Nice little looping play here to Ernesto. Dancing off the touchline. The eight woman. Adam Burling not being able to handle that pill.
I have it off of red, so it will be gray
so
ball.
Dangerous getting to the mat
red.
There when you got Christina Rader just sitting back.
Light, red ball.
Here again, here's another replay. Nice hands out of the tackle. Ernesto getting the ball back inside, but then again, you know, the 50-50. Sometimes you get it, sometimes you don't.
The wise man once said you should offload a 90-10 situation.
Absolutely.
Not
just
straight.
A better ratio than 50-50.
I would agree with you.
It's
mathematically.
It's math.
Mathematically speaking.
It seems like you guys like the scrum anyway, so.
It's a good choice by Mary Washington to go with the scrum. Obviously, the lineouts haven't been working. I think the game plan here would be get it to Raider and McLean. Let's see what they can do.
I mean, they've had so much success out wide. You'd think that's where they want to get this ball to. Off their strong hand, right-handed passes. You'd want to see them go wide here. Buxton. Coming back inside. Hogue, nice fend. She goes over the top to McLean. McLean finding some room to run inside.
Thinking about doing something. Good job.
Goes straight into the Matador defense.
Right in my grave.
She could be held up here. There's the ball on the deck. Mary Washington gets it back. To the left, Copper Carter busting it forward.
Turnover though, CSU.
And again, another turnover ball.
They're right
there
every time.
Great job by the Matadors. Now let's see what they can do with this turnover pill. Great job for a counter, Murillo. Being hauled down. Still on the feet here.
Chance.
Oh, the try score of Villa can't handle it. Hanson, a double knock on there.
Well, we have a pause in action. I want to just draw attention to one player, the wing for the Matadors, Catherine Kagari. She's done a good job of shutting down all their outside movements, as you've probably seen, that they look for that loop move.
Here's a replay coming in here on the outside. Just that inability to find hands on that pass. Kofis right behind Avila, but Hanson jumping on that opportunity nearly there. And here we go. Jade Law to put it.
Yeah, let her in. Okay, oh, just it's okay. Just relax. Just are you guys in? Okay.
Calm words from referee Lee Bryant. Just relax. This is rugby.
Okay, great. Let's go.
One, two, down.
Crouch.
Here we go. Scrum down.
Lee Bryant's seen enough, and she awards a free kick to Mary Washington. Matador's not doing themselves any favors.
That's not what they wanted there. Of course, they're going to go for the quick up here just outside the line. They're probably going for the eight-woman, Brianna Burling, and she's going to bust it up. Gets the ball back.
Oh, Cooper Carter.
There's Cooper, Copper Carter. Such a strong runner all day, right off the fringe.
Northridge has made a substitute. 22 has come on for 19. Guadalupe Moreno is coming on for Ashley Gomez, switching out the front row players, bringing a little bit of fresh legs in there.
Scrum down to Mary Washington. You'd think the Matadors need to keep them out here if they're going to have a chance in mounting a comeback.
Brianna Burling with the pick off the back, moving down the line. She's inching closer and closer and closer. They might be over, but can't she get a touchdown?
Can't she get it down?
Yeah!
Try awarded!
Brianna Burling with number two today.
And that makes it 10-27. Coming to the replay, this scrum here, Brianna picking off the back. Great support from the forwards. The Matadors just cannot get back to resource this drive. Taken straight in. That's a great, well-worked try.
Mary Washington, fans happy, excited.
Oh, absolutely. They've got to be really pleased with the way their girls are playing today.
They're all with the attempt.
Looks good, and it is good.
And Lee Bryant giving the signal for the water break. Because of the extreme temperatures here, that's hot. The players have played a game already earlier this weekend. They allowed a 5-minute water break, rehydrate. We're safety above all else at this tournament.
Absolutely, a lot of players going down due to cramping. A little word from our sponsors here, Gatorade. Gatorade knows every victory starts from within. It's the determination to come up big when it matters most. But no athlete does it alone. They need training and fuel to perform. That's how greatness comes from within. Win from within, Gatorade. And we'll be right back with more action from the second half. Stay with us. And welcome back to the second half action here. Referee Lee Bryant to get us underway. Mary Washington ahead with a 29-10 point lead. Matadors kicking off and unable to field it, but the Matadors pick up a great turn of events here. Out to Kofis, there's Camacho. Cargas, she's dangerous, she gets hauled down by McLean. Law,
under pressure,
fighting to stay on her feet. There's Jessica Morales. She's been great so far today. Gonna need her at more moments. There's the co-captain, Waters Mullen.
Oh, she squeaks through.
Smelling. Power runner. Raider trying to haul her down, but McGee's there in support. This is what the Matadors need to get back in this match.
One gray, you gotta come in from the gate. Back 10.
Coming in from the side.
Co-captain, Waters Mullen. That's our second of the day. And that's what the Matadors needed to do to get back in this match. I don't know what was in the water on that water break, but it got the Matadors fired up. Here's the penalty. Here's the quick tap. The co-captain, the presence of mind to bust it up over the line and get the try for Cal State Northridge. Great job by her there. There's some Northridge fans still at it. A lot of time left here to play. Cheering on their ladies. Kick to come, you see the hooker here. Oh, nearly there. Jessica Morello, she can do it all. Here comes the play here. The eight woman getting offended.
Gotta commit to those tackles as your George or Mary Washington.
That's what broke open the play here. Great move by Gabrielle Schmeling. Coming up big for her team when it matters most. Here's a little replay of the action here. Here's the penalty. Gotta come around in from the front.
Here we go with the restart throw. Getting ready for the kickoff. See what the Matadors have left. I think you're right, Colin. There was some magic in that water they were drinking.
Absolutely. There's a danger woman. Catherine Kergari.
Hands in back.
And again, ill discipline from Mary Washington. I hope they didn't go to sleep during that break because the Matadors are fired up.
About 15 minutes left in this game here. Mary Washington in the gray and white, up 29-15 against the Matadors from Cal State Northridge in the red, white, and black here at Stuber Stadium on the farm, Palo Alto, California.
The farm. Jessica Morello at hooker. She's gonna wanna nail this one. It's been a tough day at the offensive lineup, but she does. Great pill, long chance. Camacho, inside ball to Woods. She keeps it alive. What a fend. Keeping her legs going, supported there by Guadalupe Moreno. There's Moreno trying to dig it out. She does. Matador still with the pill. Look at this Cal State Northridge team, inspired play here. They're not done yet. They want the championship, but turned over.
Mary Washington coming out of there, looking to set a steady breakdown. The nine getting it out. Good kick by Buxton into space, and it's got wheels. It's got some legs. It's bouncing back.
Try score, Avella. Looking for a counterattack.
Wrapped
up by McLean.
Law's running out of room. Uh-oh. We have a knock-on advantage played, and the scrum will go to Mary Washington to restart play.
It's a hard spot to be put in back there when you're the deep three. When you get kicked the ball and you got to chase back to get it, and you got the chase coming down on you, the defensive line, you have to keep that ball alive or it's an immediate turnover. So they have to play a little bit of hot potato outside of the tackle. that occasion, getting the knock on Mary Washington did well there to find space with Buxton's kick. Scrum down. And it's stolen.
Up the tunnel. Come out again. Not a problem.
Straight out the tunnel. Lee Bryant says, let's settle down, ladies. Let's do that one more time.
And then after that, we have a flanker's leg who's trying to push. It's coming up before
okay.
And after this match at 3:30, the men's Division I AA National Championship, the defending champ Central Florida against Arizona. More action to come.
It's going to be quite the game, Colin. I don't know if you saw Central Florida. Either their t-shirts are that small or they're really that big.
I think they're that big. There's Chance, the captain, barreling forward. She will not be denied. Out to the left, Camacho. Oh, what a fend to the face of Turco. Looks like Waters mulling with the ball there. Looking left, Chance. Kofas out. The Trisco Villa has some room to run. He's got one to beat, Radar to beat in the back.
Oh,
does
Radar
well to shake the tackler. Supports there.
Yeah,
looks like the ball is being played on the deck.
Yep, gotta give that.
Penalty to the Matadors, and again they go quick. Guadalupe Moreno. Cato, McGee, oh.
Not back 10, Haley Fitzgerald on that tackle.
Again, here's the play here. She's already got one today. She had room to run. Had to beat one in the back in Christina Rader, but she did well there. Look at her shrug off the tackler, trying to stay on her feet. Give time for support there to resource that pill. The Matadors playing inspired right now, knowing that there's only about 12 minutes left on the play clock. They need to score a few times here to get back in contention of this match.
Lee Bryant was just having a word with the Mary Washington team about calming down, getting back 10, respecting the laws of the game. You'd hate to see a good game like this ruined by a card.
Yeah, she's done well monitoring both sides. It's been scrappy at times, and she's done a great job maintaining the structure of this match.
Excellent game management.
Jade Law, the quick tap to the co-captain. Waters Mullen, she's had two today. McGee, the inside switch. Matadors going forward. Waters Mullen again. Absolutely inspired play from Cal State Northridge.
They've got numbers
outside. They've got numbers outside.
Out wide, Camacho.
Cato to Cargia. Good. Oh, McLean, so good in defense, wraps her up. Looks like Cota there. Law digging it out. There's Peterson. Oh, that's Chance. Law, Barillo, one-handed off one to McGee. McGee gets the score.
That was a
fire
good
up Cal State Northridge.
Good set of offloads by Cal State Northridge to find McGee sitting out there. She had about three friends with her as well.
Coming back to the replay here. Absolutely amazing, inspired play from Cal State Northridge. Here's the co-captain shooting up, getting a fend, getting the ball back to her teammates, and there's Marilla. She's seen this one-handed offload before. She can do it all, gives it to her fellow forward for the try, and McGee gets the score. 20-29, this kick is really important here. Drop goal,
sneaks
attempt.
Sneaks it through, threads the needle.
Right. Chance going for the drop goal and nailing it, making it a one possession game with 10 minutes to play. I think the Matadors caught Mary Washington sleeping after that water break.
Yep.
Absolute momentum shift.
Sometimes it's a problem with that water break. It'll break up the momentum for one team. I think we're seeing it right here.
There's Evelyn Avella on your screen. Had one today. She's been instrumental in this comeback.
Cal State Northridge fans fired up. Chant defense. They can feel it. The team can feel it. What do they got left for the next 10 minutes?
This is championship rugby coming down to the final 10 minutes. And the kick is away. Back to the Tri-Star McGee, who can't handle it. Playing advantage, Mary Washington with the pill.
Copper Cooper stepping into the nine.
Buxton.
Oh.
Slight mishandling by Anissa Turco there, giving the ball.
Mary Washington's scrum falling in the
line. Scrum down here. Looks to be like Mary Washington ball. And a knock on early on, probably playing advantage here. Bryant happy to let the play go. Here we go, Thorell, and stolen. This looks like Gomez. Avila.
Just go down with it. Set that ruck, ladies. Set that
ruck. Moreno. Moreno. Out to chance. He goes to the foot. McLean backing up. Not feeling this one.
Get it here.
She feels it now.
Lee Bryant playing the advantage. I believe it was a knock. It was a knock on scrum down to Mary Washington.
And again, scrum down here for Mary Washington. You would think they want to get into the hands of the fire starter in the back line of Christina Rader. She's been absolutely electric here, scoring two unbelievably amazing tries here.
Since we've got a stoppage of play right now, Colin, the MVP award's gonna be handed out after this game. Who do you think it is?
Well, I think the standout player for Northridge has gotta be Waters Mullen. She's gotten two, she's the co-captain. She's been there doing the hard yards in the engine room all day long, getting two tries. Wonderful stuff from her. Mary Washington with the pill, and you gotta say it's this lady right here.
That's
Christina Rader. Pogue handles the pill. Ernesto, that one-handed offload we've seen from her. Buxton,
Buxton
around the corner.
Goes for the
lovely
chip.
Lovely little chip. Chance puts it in a touch. Well done by Chance there. And again, Mary Washington continues to put the pressure on as time clicks down on this clock. 6 minutes left. Here's the replay. There's Ernesto with that one-handed back off of Buxton. Nice little chip, great weight.
Good play by Fitzgerald to get
Buxton.
That line out.
Switch to Turco.
Turco moving.
Great fend.
Release run 15.
She's been an apex sub, absolutely.
Heavy contestant for that ball right now.
Oh, turnover.
Cal State somehow sneaks out there.
Oh.
Rader there to field it, letting it bounce around though.
That's great stuff for Morillo. She kicks and she's the first one down there to give chase.
Rader looking for some space. She's found it on the edge.
The danger by Rader. And again, she threatens. Goes in for the hat trick. Christina Rader. Holy cow.
She's had a pretty decent game today.
And again, going in for a third. We were just talking about this young lady. Look at this. Goes to the outside, finds a space, in and out move. Shakes off the tackler, finds a space down the sideline, and just easy in and out. Beats Cato, beating everyone. Do it yourself, go on girl. Get it under the sticks, that's her third.
I like her commitment to the run. When she has that ball in hand, she's going to one place and she's going hard.
She knows one speed. Absolutely. Go hard or go home. Lovely stuff.
Couple substitutes coming on. Mary Washington is bringing number 7 out, Amy Everett, and bringing number 22 in, Elise Carter, as well as number 1, Alicia Umberg, and number 24 for Mary Washington, Stephanie Reuter, coming into the front row. Cal State Northridge, the Matadors, bringing number 14, Catherine Cargilla off, and bringing on number 16, Maggie Alea. Let's see what kind of impact they have on the game with only 4 minutes remaining.
5 minutes left to play. Cal State has certainly been playing inspired, but maybe a little too much to come back from here, but this could be something. Referee Lee Bryant brings back the infraction. Knock on. Scrum down to Mary Washington. 3 minutes and 30 seconds left to play. 14 points the difference. Tough ask for the Matadors here to get two converted tries in 3 minutes.
Yep. Points have not been easy to come by.
Come down through all, decides to pick weak. Kick straight out to touch. Interesting tactic here. Not really sure.
Mary Washington went straight to touch, had it roll for touch.
What was happening there?
Red, take a step, please. Thank you.
Where it was kicked, because it went straight out.
Here we go. Time for a Matadors to mount an attack. They need to get one quickly here if they're going to have an opportunity to come back and work the clock. Overthrow. Great fend. That's Kelsey Herrick. But she turns the ball over. Law to Murillo. Bryant has been so good on the day. Calling the infractions, and she says, forward pass, bring it down for a scrum, Mary Washington. Here's a replay of the action. There's the tackle and the rip from the captain. Chance, unlucky there. Nice little pop there from Sophia Thorault on the hooker.
She's had a quiet little game today, too. She's had to really work hard to get that ball out of the back of the rucks, get it to the back.
Her service has been amazing. Yes. And that's the reason some of these backs have had such a great opportunity to score and run these great lines, is just the quality of the service that Thorault's been giving throughout the entire match. Ooh. Camacho out the chance. We've got Ayala.
Release right now!
And again, another counter break, turnover.
No, you have to come in from the gate, back.
Penalty to the Matadors. A minute left on the clock, and they score quickly here and get the kickoff in. Could have some more rugby. Murillo.
Great move, that's fine.
Oh, what a steal.
Mary Washington getting the advantage, not releasing by the Matadors.
Mary Washington happy to slow this thing down here. Thorault having a word with her ladies. Looking the touch and doesn't have enough leg on it. Avila
going.
Ooh. Oh, great tackle there by Hogue.
Pushed out though by the number 13 from Mary Washington. Good effort defensively. Maddie Ernesto.
Marissa Navarro there getting pushed out. She's been amazing. Doing the quiet work at the lock position in the line out.
Mary Washington taking the time. No rush. They're in the lead.
You got to think this would be the last throw in here.
Overthrow, but Mary Washington's able to.
Not straight. What would you like?
Not straight.
Not straight.
Cal State.
Bryant blows it up, scrum down for the Matadors. One last chance for them. Possibly get a consolation try here. Finish their championship run.
We got it. I got 30 seconds, ladies.
With a score. It would be fitting for the second half performance. Absolutely inspired performance by the Matadors. Fight back.
and stay in this match. Great to see them going out with one more try here.
Yep.
McGee picking weak side. Nice offload inside to Moreno. Back to McGee. She's been amazing.
Avila.
There's Jessica Murillo. Wow. Waters Mullen, the two-time try scorer and co-captain of this Northridge.
Kind of rocked by Mary Washington, looking for it. See what Lee Bryant calls here. Not rolling away on the Matadors. Mary Washington's ball.
I think this would have to be it here. The kick to touch, finds it.
That's it.
And that's the game. Mary Washington. Great, wonderful pass to play from both teams. Mary Washington come out the victors. Great play from both sides, as you see Mary Washington celebrating on the field. Oh, wonderful stuff there, but player of the match. She had three tries. She put the team on her back with her runs and her defense. So many try-saving tackles and scoring through herself. And that had to be Raider in the back with the number 10 jersey.
Definitely did a great job today. She was a standout player for Mary Washington for sure.
Absolutely. Great team effort all around, but she definitely had a lot of the plays. Here she is on your screen, breaking around the outside, cutting inside, finding room to run. Inspiring play from her. Wonderful for Mary Washington to get this, but absolutely hats off to Cal State Northridge. You see here the 8-woman, Gabrielle Schmeling. She had a massive day. Aliyah Woods coming through. Almost mounted the comeback needed to get this championship. And there's the woman of the hour, Christina Raider, getting it off
to McClain. Setting the ruck.
Great stuff, Kofis. So many talented rugby athletes here at this stage.
Here we go with the 2014 Division II National Championship Award Ceremony.
And with the Women's Division II Championship Trophy Presentation, we've got Frank Merrill, the Match Commissioner, Rich Cortez, the Collegiate Director, Tom Breckenridge, Associate College Director, and Kevin Battle, the D1A Commissioner. Tam Breckenridge, excuse me.
Frank Merrill is there on the screen in the blue shirt.
Smiles all around on this Mary Washington team. There's McClain.
Exciting moments for these athletes. Hard season, hard fought matches coming down here.
Absolutely.
Playing two games in 2 days. Now getting crowned national championships.
A whole season with your ladies, your teammates, coming all the way here to Stanford, California to compete in a championship. They gotta be proud of the effort they put in. Cal State Northridge, unlucky.
But they have
but getting the number two spot, nothing to be ashamed of.
Nothing at all.
All their heads held high. Yep. Some tears of joy coming in there from maybe some of the graduating seniors.
Great, great job too by first year head coach Christina Alatorre. Good standard to set. Hopefully they'll be back next year. Right now the votes are being tallied for the 2014 MVP of the game. We're all
eager. I've got my predictions.
I got a good idea of who it is too. Hugs all around. Great time. They're still finishing up the medals on both sides.
Absolutely blinder of a championship match here today. Winner just deserves. Wonderful stuff. Smiles all around. Congratulations to Mary Washington. Absolutely inspired play.